Hello and welcome back. We are playing as the little parasite that could inside the United States. We are playing as the Indian Territory, trying to eventually claw our way out of the belly of the United States. Okay, last episode we 15x'd our population because we had forgotten the previous episode to turn on migration controls. No migration controls, even though this is the most important element of the run, so that was a bit of a flub. Now we're sitting here with just insane loyalists versus radicals, you know. Looking in here, everyone's happy with us. The rural folks somehow got powerful again. Got to kind of keep an eye on these bonuses because the 10% infrastructure bonus is painful when you lose it. So this is just something to keep in mind and maybe be cognizant of. Another thing we're going to do here is there's a nice little trick. When you go into this, you can pay military wages and you can pay more military wages to make the military happy. You can't do this if there's none. But if there's just one, and even if they don't have any military goods, you can now overpay that one once this finishes. So we'll actually kick this to the front of the queue in order to just kind of pay a little bit more for some approval rating in the barracks. We also are going to start playing on speed 4 now because we are looking to, in the near future, try and find some spot to pick to go to war with the United States, which is going to be, like, where we want to be. Industrialists are now powerful. This is fantastic. This is something we've really been hoping for because now we are doubling their bonuses for Engines of Progress and Job Creators. And Engines of Progress is a really good one. Job Creators is a really good one. These three interest groups each have the most powerful bonuses you can give. The rural folks bonuses are okay. The petite bourgeoisie, they're okay. But we are currently researching shift work, because I thought we had this before, so we built up to the 51 cap, but really we just needed to build up to the 31 cap. So once we finish that, we will be getting another 20% throughput bonus for a total throughput bonus of 90%, which is going to be huge. And that's kind of what we're doing. We're turning a really big corner here. We've like nearly, our economy is like burring like straight up in a way that, pausing, it's gonna start getting hard to keep up with the construction, but I think we'll find a way to manage. We're gonna up this. I expect these to become popular, profitable at some point. I mean, we're making a ton of money. We can up construction even more. We are really turning a corner here, especially with the increased investment pool transfer, both from job creators as well as, you know, getting pretty good tech in the form of mutual funds, which allows you to do way more capitalists, which is also how we got them to be powerful in the first place in order to get the double bonus from them. And we, like, our government's super righteous. I think we're going to try and stay on landed voting for quite a long time if we can, because this way we can, it's easy to keep the capitalists strong. Normally the capitalists drop off in strength as the trade unionists and intelligentsia, or mainly the trade unionists, pick up. And if we can maintain this balance of 3, we will be in really good shape. So that's kind of what's going on now. We, of course, I think we can expand construction a little more here. Wait, we might even hit the construction cap pretty soon here. Free trade party. So this might be bad for us, but let's take a look. This is fine. They want to join the Social Democratic Party, which would increase our clout, which would be maybe something we're interested in. But currently we're running no penalty for having groups in the opposition. We're just getting a ton of loyalists every month, so this is okay. We'll kind of sit on this. We could even increase taxes and stay in that bracket, I think. Yeah, we would stay in the righteous government bracket even if we increase taxes, but I don't think we need to increase taxes here. I think we're doing just fine with as is. We are draining the investment pool by 8k, so really we're making 27k, but that's still quite a lot. We will actually, in order to make it so that we can transition better, we're going to shift these over to later PMs. And the reason why is there is a penalty for switching your PM, but if you already have just one building on the PM, there's not a penalty for expanding from 1 to 100. And so, other than, like, it takes a while to employ and, like, these types of things. So, we're just gonna do that. So we're going to be overpaying a little bit for some flexibility, and we will add some arms industries and some munitions plants. Just kind of a couple levels of each. Swap over all the PMs to what we want. And this way, if we do end up getting a little bit of a fight with the United States at some point, we'll maybe be a little bit better, better fit to, you know, fight them. And also, we will be getting, like, a huge throughput bonus from the industrial organizers plus encouraging manufacturing. We should be able to outcompete the American... Well, actually, we probably can't outcompete them because the wages in our province are going to be higher than theirs. So we maybe don't outcompete just because, like, wages are going to be higher wherever we're trying to compete with, like, this munitions plant, for example. Which is not very productive. But okay. I digress. I digest, too. Add a little bit of a snack. Watching this go 15x, that was a snack, too. So whichever one of them is less powerful, we're going to try and empower the other. Wow, is this for realsies? They're like exactly the same. The free trade party has been trending up. We will do the trade unionist. We want to keep them both above 18%. It's 20% to become powerful, and then you need to stay above 18 to stay powerful. We do want to swap over to mass conscription at some point in time. Trade unions like mass conscription. That's interesting. I think now we can come in and pay them extra, and a little bit extra of almost nothing is, you know, not a lot, but it will give 2% approval on them, and it will, over time, kind of keep the loyalists on them high. We can turn on the dynamites on the boom booms. We do not have any dynamite production ourselves, so maybe we want to get on that a little bit, and we will take a look at our infrastructure. It should be doing pretty good because we have the peasant bonus. But we got a lot of things in the queue, and we have the railway. We'll be able to take care of it. Okay, we're just going to kick a railway at the back of this. I think that should be about what we need. We are subbing. The free trade party wins, so now the free trade party has got to come back into government. So, the party's over. We were trying to hold out and, you know, swap over to primary, the schools, which the industrialists don't like. Unfortunate. We are going to have to reform the government and put them in, though. We will just choose this, the most legitimate government, and we can consider... If we lower taxes by 2 notches, which I think we can afford... You drunkard, you. If we do that, then we will still be the righteous, which will give us more loyalists. And do we have to? So these two parties will fuse as well. Which, kind of content to have the rural folk in there, because that means the rural folk can't become marginalized. And so we can still extract their bonus. We will, I think, decrease the taxes, so we get that up in there. To maintain the righteous government. But that's good. So, just kind of keep on keeping on. In this front, we have excess construction. Why don't we... really... I guess we go with furniture, because furniture is employing, at least. I'm gonna add... I think we're already too railroaded up a little bit here, so we're gonna add another 10 here, and then a railroad, and then we're gonna need... we're gonna take a look. We don't have any food industries. We definitely don't want to collapse and have no paper mills and no glassworks, so... We're going to start our, we're going to start expanding other stuff as well. And they should be relatively profitable with the 40% bonus from both having the industrialists happy, or not the industrialists, the trade unionists happy, and from us encouraging manufacturing here, which makes them outcompete probably most of them in the US market, except for the fact that our labor is going to be more expensive as well, because our standard of living is high, but that drives our migration, which is why we 15x'd our population last episode. This is continuing to crank up, which is really, really good for having approval rating on everyone being high. You know, everybody is happy. Literally everyone is positive. Don't want to dip below. Yeah, I want to stay above this 90. Saw it oscillating back and forth there a little bit. We would like to come on to compulsory primary school. Not sure if this happens in the near future, but this allows us to increase education a little bit, which would be nice. We can increase... Let's increase health system so we have fewer pops dying off. We can do the same with workplace safety. And then what we can do is we will probably almost certainly need to expand the bureaucracy to afford all that. And we are running a pretty tight ship here. The investment pool is expanding by quite a bit, so we could expand construction even more here. We like actually would not mind deficit spending for a while, so we are going to expand the construction a little bit more than that. And then we will have a look-see. Let's make sure all these are auto-expanding except the textile mills. The textile mills, we've gotten them to 51. We want to focus on getting other buildings to 51 before we really expand the textile mills more. The demand for the textiles is being driven by the United States exporting them. This is a small deficit, and we're draining the investment pool slowly. I think we want to kick slightly bigger. But pretty soon here, we're going to run out of slots for the construction, so... We might just want to trend towards that phenomenon anyways. And yeah, unfortunately, there's not a whole lot we can do like in terms of trade or anything because of our very isolated status. We can trade with the Mexican market, and that's about it. Can we import silk from them, though? I don't think so. I don't think they have silk. Yeah, they don't have silk, which is kind of the biggest thing we need. We are building that bureaucratic center, which will be helpful. We can't declare neutrality there, because reasons. The radicalism on wealth voting is very low, which is great. We only have 200 radical, which is fantastic for us. Can we switch to elected bureaucrats right now? Yeah, we can, which would be a little bit better. Now, the problem with electric bureaucrats for us is it'll make the intelligentsia weaker in favor of the petite bourgeoisie, and it will kind of hurt our triple balance of maintaining those guys strong. So what we'll do is we'll expand the unis to compensate for this. We'll take a look at our infrastructure. We have another 20 available, so we'll add a railway. We're going to put it at the front of the queue instead of the back of the queue, and then we will start expanding... all these industries a little bit more, and then we will take a look here. And we can improve this one. Can't make this. We can switch to explosive shells and publicly trade. We can switch to electricity, but there's no electricity in the market, and we do not want to start building the electricity until we can get on something like capacitors, which is not, we're not too far from electrical capacitors, I suppose. We do want to go Allen Eden next, I think. Considering we no longer have the trade unions in government, so going human rights to do compulsory primary school becomes less appealing, which is kind of what we were on before. So I think we're just going to go Allen Eden and try and get into art silk as quickly as possible. So we're going to go alanine, vulcanization, and then art silk. And pump jacks will be spread by then. Pollution? What? Is this a new patch? Did we get patched? Okay. We'll take some measures. I don't know... Okay, that's news to me. I don't know if this is a new patch or something, and I somehow didn't know about it. We're fine giving the intelligentsia more strength. Yeah, this is fine. That is less fine. We are losing more money than we anticipated. Some of these buildings have become less profitable. We are running a hardwood shortage. Can we import hardwood from Mexico? No, because we have no control over anything. Jeez, we're like a child. So I'm going to swap this interest to Canada. Try and see if we can import from Canada. This is a little bit... What caused the dramatic shift? There was a hike in costs here. Was that really just the increased demand for both goods and increased wages by standard living coming up? Standard living shot up because we decreased taxes 2 notches in order to maintain the legitimacy, which increased all the government wages. That makes sense. I think that's it. So we might have to come off a righteous government here by increasing taxes a little, but let's just deficit this through for a little while here and see what we can do, because we will be attracting pops a little bit faster with this higher standard of living. So, and we still have more space in the construction queue, so, I mean, these are relatively profitable at the moment. So, are we running an infrastructure problem? No, we're not. Just gonna kick one of those at the back of the queue. Alright, the paper's relatively profitable, so we'll just add to the paper. Something like this. Check RPMs. I mean, we're paying a little bit for this, but... Maybe we want to get on electricity soon here? Oh, it's because the trade union is deactivated. This is what happened. We are no longer getting the workforce ratio. Would also explain what's going on. But elected bureaucrats is a little bit more efficient for us. Hopefully it's worth it. The petite bourgeoisie gets stronger off of it. Maybe it's really not worth it. If we can't maintain the balance of these three interest groups, because the petite bourgeoisie got stronger, then it will be a not worth it. So, we'll see, I guess. Colonial exploitation is not worth doing. But for now we can increase our institutions, so that's a positive. Can increase them quite a bit here. And then... And the public schooling and public health insurance are really, really nice with this high standard of living here. Or sorry, private, rather. We're no longer super legitimate, so we're going to increase this a little bit. Because we can't get inside this band of over 90 anyways, unfortunately. Still only have 100 radicals. So overall doing quite well still. I had like a thought and I lost it. I was trying to... There's something I wanted to do. I can't remember now. I mean, probably construct more, right? Shift work's gonna be huge for us. Because this is gonna go from 70 to 90, which is gonna be the equivalent of like getting 20 more textile mills for free, right? Because we have 50 of them, so 20% more of 50. Of course, it's not going to be like 20 more of textile mills as efficient as the one we have, but it is going to be pretty substantive. I mean... That is, let's see, 45, right? I can do math. And that's your 51. Can build rails as needed. Yeah, we can tolerate this minus 31k for a while. Huge. Now we get aniline, which is also going to be big for us. And now we have a 90% throughput bonus. Huge. Producing a ton of goods. Looks like our legitimacy has risen a little bit, so we can lower this again. And then now we are righteous again. Maybe unnecessary, though. I think we could cruise like this for a little while longer, so we're gonna do that. Are gonna need... Well, actually, no, I want to keep the approval high on these guys. So, I'm going to do that. I think we could eat this 50k for quite a while. We have gold reserves of 5 mil. And now that we have elected bureaucrats, we can really up the institutions. These help a lot for making institutions cheap. And we have nearly every institution, so... Don't want to allow child labor, I don't think. This is coming up, which is increasing our tech research. We have a lot of unis, too, relative to population. Which is one of the reasons the intelligentsia are doing so well. Let's double check. Or that cloud, we have it here. Yeah, we're keeping all three of them strong. The industrialists do have a little bit of concern for them, but they're currently in the government, so... this is uncomfortable. Really want that to be a 91 or whatever, but... Oh, the trade unions get booted? Or the rural folk get booted? We didn't want that to happen. That's unfortunate. We want them around, which means we might be... How are we doing on infrastructure? Yeah, we're doing bad on infrastructure now, because we lost their 10% bonus. So let's just drop another two railroads at the front of the queue and hope, and kick these to the back of the queue. Which should help a little bit. Oh no, we can't tolerate any of that. Oh, we're still increasing to it anyways. Yep. Cool beans. This needs to come down, though. So we are going to increase taxes, and we're going to increase taxes by quite a bit to bring it down, which of course takes us off of the righteous government. Since we're off it anyways, we'll just come off of it a little bit more. Because that is not quite tenable for us. God, we're just like plus 21ing those furniture manufacturers. That is going to be quite the uptick. Was discovered in SAS. Let's take a look at their economy versus ours. We're at 51 billion. Last we checked, we were roughly a third of the United States economy. Now we're roughly a half. Starting to get there. Would really love to go mass conscription. Let's double check. I know we need a tech for it, but I can't remember which one because I don't go mass conscript too much. We need enlistment offices. Which I think is a military tech. And it's this one. Could just wait for it to nat spread to us, I think. Instead of going our way, out of our way. It's not like we want to fight the US immediately. We also have this awkward spot where we don't want to decrease our relations with them. Unless we are going to fight them, so... Because we don't want them to annex us. They were, like, domineering, they could just annex us, and it just scuffs the whole run. And we haven't saved. Let's save now, actually. We've just had the client open, and we've just played three different sessions, taking a break in between each one. And so, saving seems like a good look, just in case something weird happens. Don't want to scuff the run. We might scuff the run. How do we make the trade unions a little bit happier with us? I guess we... have to do the child laws. We could go after Aniline, we could go back to trying to get human rights. The intelligentsia will support the passing of that law. It is a law that we want. The law I'm talking about is the one that allows us to get compulsory primary school, so. Hurrah for the health system. Not hurrah for my capacity to keep the construction queue going in a reasonable fashion. Let's just add an extra. And then wait a week so that it finishes first and starts employing. And then we're going to add a bunch to the queue. And then a rail, maybe. Something like that, and then maybe another rail. I don't know. Oop. We could star Oklahoma. It's our only city. By city, I mean, yeah. Suppose we want to make glass a little bit more as well. Only have a 42% throughput bonus here. We are starting to dip that back down, which is decreasing all of the costs of our government wages, which is nice. Let's take a look. We are keeping radicals really low, despite this. You know, not running the super legit government. Unfortunately, the trade unionists, like, I think our loyalists have dipped as well. Yeah. We will make the trade unionists happy when we start switching the law thing. Also, would very much not mind deficit spending. Why don't we just add another one of these in the back? Now those are finished. Or we have the max throughput bonus on these, and the United States managed to solve the hardwood problem. Allegedly. Yeah, they are. We are a very, very big part of that economy. Yeah, I'm thinking actually maybe we would have not wanted the petite bourgeoisie to be around at all. Oh well. Like, so if we wanted to completely stomp them out, we could have stayed on appointed bureaucrats. This is kind of a little bit of a nuanced thing, but I think it would have been a fair way to play. But yeah, population is just nutter. Expanding. Super pleased with that. Loyalists are coming down because we are not 90 legitimate, we are 80 legitimate. But we're also getting to charge a little bit more on the taxes, and this is fine. We are slowing down the deficit spending, which we're going to continue doing for a while. Booming industries. I think we take the throughput on the mines. I think we have quite a few coal mines. Yeah, we do. Which suddenly makes us a ton of money, it looks like. Or we don't have a brain and we can't keep the construction queue going. Oh, oil gets discovered here. That is fantastic. We'll just max that out, because why not? I mean, I could think of reasons why not, but don't at me, bro. We're gonna 51 this. As suppose we could, at the end of this, put a food industry now and an art industry, and we just have everything except for power. Let's make everything auto-expanding except for the stuff we've 51'd already. Politician died. That's possibly a big deal. What's the new one? A moderate and... not very exciting. Hey, we have built through our deficit, it looks like. Except we actually do want to run a deficit, so... if you got them, smoke them. We're going to max construction possible here. I keep looking for this tab, but I switched over the thing. We do have electricity in the market now, so we will turn on some of the electricity PMs, like the logging camps. We also will want to expand the electricity ourselves, but the problem is he building it in New York or some shit? Can we let him build the electricity for us? We're gonna keep it not for profit, and then this one we'll make publicly traded and put this on auto expand. And we'll probably need a rail here, so we'll just add it at the front. It'll take care of itself. We do want to go for art soap relatively early here, so we're gonna go vulcanization because open hearth process is that spreading. Unless I don't have eyes, I do have eyes. But actually, kind of want to go human rights. We've already put a lot of investment into it. It's not net spreading. I think. If it is net spreading, we won't research it. No, it's not net spreading, so we do want, in order to get the compulsory primary school unlocked. We now cannot build any more construction, so we're capped. So we cannot grow the economy faster than it is growing now. Which is a little bit of a problem. Are we not spreading the mill tech we need? We need enlistment offices at some point. What is your military look like, my guy? Our GDP is not, like, exploding or anything. We are siphoning off a good amount of pops. So we will be lowering taxes as we get more money because we can't increase construction anymore. So it do be like that sometimes. I wonder if we increase this by 2 levels? No. I was seeing if we could get a consumption tax that would pay for itself, but we cannot. That line's still going like straight up though, so... pretty happy with that. Happy we have, you know, triple digit approval. Or radicals, rather. Really would like the trade unions to be... there's a big reason why we're researching this tech is because we want to get the trade unions above plus 10 opinion of us for their bonus. How are we doing on infrastructure? Kind of good. My guesstimation's working out. We're putting in another 2 railroads here, so we should be... Yeah, we should be in pretty good shape once we finish all that. We'll put another one at the end here. And then some more synthetic plants. Because the synthetic plants are how we are going to get the silk. Do not have silk. The United States refuses to import it. It's really a tragedy. I suppose these techs that increase, like elevators is going to be really big for us because it increases the construction center max level. So we might have to go elevators like faster than we've ever done in a run. Or prioritize it higher. Just a quick reminder that in this run we have four, count of four, edicts in this one place. If we ever get a ruler who makes edicts cheaper, we might just switch back to monarchy or something. Would not hate shifting to old age pensions, but I think I'm fine. Well, the industrialists can maybe lose a little bit of clout. I don't know. Would really love to see the rural folk make a resurgence, but I don't think that's going to happen. Classic shortage. We can't solve that, so... Who's doing good in the election? The Free Trade Party is doing quite good, so probably just going to run it back, I guess. But in the meantime, we will expand our bureaucracy. I love bureaucracy. We'll just keep that where it's at. Just watching for any shakeups here. We do have the three groups powerful that we want powerful. We just wish we had more approval. Wish, wish, wish. That's not how it works, though. I mean, the prestige doesn't do anything to us. For us, we will just take the malice for 5 years. We're just gonna put another 10 in. Not spending that on anything, but these should be pretty profitable, so we'll start turning it up. We don't need the arms yet. I wonder if we can diplomatically get out and then join their market. This would be like kind of the, well, this is not the most ideal situation. What most ideal would be us taking Texas as we get out somehow. So we get onto the coast, because just Texas will put us on the coast. Something about Texas toast. Yeah, this is the most legitimate government we can field currently. Maybe we can't expand these as fast as I think, though, because too much demand for sulfur. Central Archives complete. You're telling me?
I love bureaucracy.
We don't want to take that, though. Almost never want to take that one, really. I mean, maybe another rail after this, and then... Electric rails would be pretty big as well. Just a smattering of things. We have nothing close to 51, otherwise we would try and complete 251 to get the max economy scale throughput bonus. The closer you get to 51, the more valuable moving to 51 is, because that will give you the max throughput bonus. This is kind of close. Maybe this pushes what we do next. Pushing this up. It's not even anywhere near fully employed though, so... I'm not sure there's enough demand. Like, this place isn't nearly fully employed either, but... I mean... Yeah. Yeah, can't do much of anything. can only try and trade with either Canada or Mexico, really. Because that's all we can declare interest in. Is that... Did you somehow become... No. Thought they somehow became a centralized power. I was wondering how they did that. It's a neat trick. We actually kind of want to deficit spend a little bit, so I'm tempted to just lower taxes. You know, feed the beast, rise this. Could expand, start expanding the military too. Except I think when we expand the military, we're gonna wanna like 0 to 100 it. I don't think we wanna do that before Trench. I think we're gonna go for a really late gameplay on the US. The US is so strong in this run too. But once we leave their market, they will be really clapped out. So we have about 16, about 2 railroads in the way. Oh, these are employing pretty well. So maybe we're gonna turn the lights on sometime soon. Probably not. This takes 670 electricity. I think that's more than the entire market. Yeah. Nearly doubling the buy orders, but there's a shortage of electricity, so I guess it's good enough to employ. Electricity is something that's kind of hard to employ on, but... We're also trying to diversify a little bit because we want to, in the semi-near future, be able to go against the United States, and so this diversity is an essential component to that. So you're not employing very well, but once you get to the... This is maybe about what we want because we want to be able to switch to Rayon here. I'm gonna get human rights and go for that. Maybe another rail in here. And we will go for the silks. So we're gonna need to go vulcanization, which is mat spreading, which is nice, but then we wanna go art silk. And then finally we can go the laws for compulsory primary school. Decent chance of it stalling out because the industrialists are in government, so it's not gonna have the best pass. But we can't take the industrialists out of government because they are the supreme leader, not the intelligentsia, so... Oh well. I guess this is kind of nearing the throughput bonus, isn't it? Ish? Maybe. Just maybe. We want to do something like this. Let's take care of that, and then, Oh, that's all it. That's all of them. Okay. I take it all back. Well, we have some more expanding to do. I guess we're gonna take this... We can either take steel to 51, or synthetic plants to 51. Kind of leaning towards the synthetic plants, because that will allow us to turn on this. Maybe steel is just the way to go. Yes, please. So now we can even raise taxes and still be max legitimacy. But we will just take the extra loyalists. And this gets turned on, which is crazy good. Workforce ratio is up. This should make everything more profitable. We will do this, I think. Because we still get to be inside righteous government despite the taxes being high. And it's a bit more on point with the, kind of the deficit I want to be running here. We are still siphoning off a good amount of pops. One of the problems is we're going to have to try and have a lot more pops, I think, before we fight them. And we're only siphoning off from them. And we're trying to siphon off... I don't know, maybe 10 mil is like kind of the target we need to hit. not. Ugly, ugly. We're gonna keep going for it, but that's not a good pair of ticks for us. Well, that's nice. We can put in a consumption tax, or we can remove an edict and start bolstering a group, or suppressing a group. I don't think we want to bolster or suppress any of this, so we'll just put in a consumption tax. That's a little nice. It's not super necessary, but it's okay. Booming oil industry. Combustion engine time. Open hearth process is going to be a little bit nice too. We are way overproduced on the steel. I think we're going to open up the auto expand on this again. And even do some of this action. Because those are really profitable. Oop. We are somehow running a huge infrastructure penalty. What happened? Did we just overbuild like a chump? You're employed. So we might have just overbuilt like a chump. I mean, we got a lot of these building and cranking up. Maybe we didn't overbuild like a chump, but that's like 80 over. That's like not a small thing. Maybe we're getting a malice somewhere. I think we can afford that bureaucracy hit, but I kind of don't want to pay it for another 8% tick, so we're just going to nix this for now. Which, of course, now the trade unions aren't happy with this anymore, but that's fine. I guess we could have kept running it, just sitting in the ground, just for the approval. Could go protect its speech for the tech spread. Kind of like this authority, though. Interesting that I could go cultural exclusion and no one has a problem with it. Not going to, because the immigration's better, but it's just interesting. Turn on open hearth process. This is probably not going to be the most profitable. I guess it is. I mean, we need to employ less guys to get the same effect. In terms of steel, probably reach a similar equilibrium, but just cheapens labor everywhere. Something like this. His GDP cranked up quite a bit in the past few. A lot of it's driven by a huge manufacturing industry. Cannot increase construction anymore. This is a tragedy. This is a farce against humanity. We want more construction. Staying on triple digits for this. Really want the trade unionists to be happier. But, yep, this is the only thing. We got just gotta wait the however long. 8 months. Go again. Wow. Is that just because we can't keep a queue filled? It is. Let's see. How are we using even more infrastructure? We have, like, so many rails in here, though. We're just, like, lagging on the rails. Okay. Add another couple rails, because I'd rather overbuild the rails, you know, than like hit that problem. And we'll just max those out and then add another couple rails. And then... I mean, I guess we could... No, I don't want to 51 that. Are any of these places employed pretty well? This is kind of employed. Let's expand that a little bit. You guys, nah. You guys, no. You guys, definitely. So, expand this a little bit. We have a ton of money now. This is with the huge infrastructure problem. Why don't we just add two more rails, just in case, I guess. We're gonna be overbuilt, and we're gonna get electric rails, and then we're gonna be sad. That is kind of next on the thing. We're gonna go art silk, and then electrical capacitors, and then electric railways. And we will be in very good shape then. Yeah, we have so many rails at the top of the queue. Trying to fix this problem. Our guesstimations were no longer on the money. Do we have... Let's put this at the back. To give the rails more time to finish. Yeah, and then... Expand this in preparation of the electric rails. And then add a couple more of these to the top of the queue. This way we definitely don't finish anything. Before we get the infrastructure. Yeah, so we should be fine here. And we're making so much money that we can lower taxes. Can lower them twice, actually. Kind of even wanted to be deficit spending, so we could lower them even more. Because that's going to raise the standard of living. We're just going to be content with the lower twice, because this is going to raise the standard of living, pull in more migrants. I guess maybe we want to actually kind of build a little bit of a surplus now, because we are going to, at some point, just, you know, drop 99 barracks. When we decide we've had enough of the U.S. But I don't think that's going to be this episode, or any... where particularly close. I think we're going to want to, like, we're going to want to get ahead on literacy and then get ahead on mil tech. So maybe this is where we sink the extra money right now, actually. Just double that and add some of that. And at some point, we're going to want to do something with this arable land. The thing is it does benefit from economies of scale, so we'd really love to just build one thing, but then I'm concerned that we should just try and make ourselves less vulnerable by, you know, not just building one thing. So I'm thinking I might just build 5 wheat farms and the rest cotton plantations. The 5 wheat farms just to try and supply us with a little bit of grain. Although it's nowhere near enough, so, like, why even bother at that point? Or you could just do all grain, but this doesn't feel as good. We go art silk so we can finally get silk in our market. So this will make 1.2 thousand silk. And how much silk do you need? Okay, so more than enough silk we will have. I do think we need to really prioritize this a bit more. So why don't we do some of that? Building up a little bit of a surplus. This is coming up. So we've also lowered taxes 2 notches. We do have extra authority if we eventually... I guess when we decide to build 9 buildings, we'll want to do enlistment efforts. So we can take off the consumption tax, put on enlistment efforts. I'm guessing we want to do that once we have, like, squad infantry, maybe? I'm not sure. I think we want to get ahead on tech to do that. Capacitors and then electric railroads are the, like, two big things, and then I think we're done for up in here for a while. Telephone's not spreading to us, which is something notable. Yeah, just been chill expansion so for the most part. You know, we are past 50% of our overlord's GDP, and notably, we are paying them 50k from being a puppet. So we would really like to get depuppet. Let's, we can declare interest. No, not very. All right, we're gonna declare an interest in we're gonna declare an interest in Canada. We have an interest in Canada, and we're gonna start trying to improve relations. And I think we can improve relations with the... Why can't we improve UK? Don't you have an interest in Canada as the UK? Tragic. Okay, we're gonna try with Russia. Well, something went horribly wrong. Oh, we're building stuff that the investment pool doesn't pay for. That's what went wrong. What did they not pay for? Oh, the unis? Okay, yeah, that's fine. The 7 unis. Pretty big uptick. Just trying to pull ahead in tech here. How are you doing on infra? F it, we'll just go to 50, you know? That seems like a good number. These are full employed, but we also only have 3 right now. So, I don't know, it's a bit hard to guess. We're going to want to take everything to 51 at some point, so 51 plus. We're letting this naturally expand now. Really want to get this art silk up in here. Just taking a screen, might use it in the thumb. Strand living's nice. We want that deficit to be there. For now, otherwise we could just increase the taxes to take care of it. Are we super legitimate? We are righteous. These guys aren't budging. Ooh, it's been 8 months though. Let's do this. Leroy Jenkins. Now, again, it has a pretty high chance of stalling out because the industrialists who are in government oppose it. So this is an unfortunate part, but we can't take the industrials out of government and stay super legitimate, nor can we put the trade unions in and stay super legitimate. So this is the soup we're swimming in. Socialist demagogue. Kind of don't want a stream of radicals, but it is what it is. I think we just expand the bureaucracy. Gonna want to, well, we're pretty far from telephone switchboards, actually. We can just do 2 levels, so we don't have to worry about it as much later. Yeah, pop is, we're siphoning off a lot of pops from them. Yeah, just, you know, trugging along. Maybe speed 4 was a bit of a mistake. We keep on, like, getting problems with the queue, though. We're not overbuilt. How many rails do we have in the queue? 3. We'll put another one in the queue and then start dropping some more of these. These are starting to have a hard time employing. Let's expand these by 10, I guess. And these by 10. I don't know. Something like this. We get compulsory primary school, which gives us They were at 6 before. Why'd you do that? Why aren't you 10? Come on. Alright. But everyone's pretty loyal. And also notably, we can now turn up to the max level once we get more bureaucracy. So I guess we'll just add another couple or something. Are running minus 89k, which is a little bit much, but our investment pool is growing. Because the government admins are not paid for by that queue, so this is kind of an acceptable amount to be running. We're going to start running a surplus soon, and then we're not going to be able to deficit spend out of the surplus, because we are going to be on... I just had the biggest brain fart. We're stuck on 25 construction centers. So we can't up the construction centers. Like, this is the world. This is the soup we're swimming in. And by super swimming in, I mean the United States. We're swimming in their soup. But we are growing much faster than they are, and soon our economy will be bigger than theirs. But the problem is like, how do we fight them from the outside in? Luckily, when we have a rev against them, we maintain access to their market. So that is one fortunate thing. But we have to take taxes, I think. I don't think there's a way to do this without taking taxes. Or we could take Arkansas, Louisiana, or whatever. But, probably want to take the rest of Oklahoma. Would be nice to do. This coming up. Let's see if we're hitting the cap on the... So I don't think we're on cap. So we can expand the unis even more. They do benefit from economies of scale, which I guess makes sense, but... I just don't know what arable land we want, or what we want to do. I think cotton plantations would be the most profitable. This would be flexible because it would give us both fabric and food. This would give us more of the like minimum requirements to make our society work. I think we just worry about it once we're about to get booted from their market, though. And then I think it might be the wheat farms. Feminism's great. Nobody is a feminist. But what this allows us to do, women's suffrage gives us workforce ratio. And it decreases the birth rate, but most of our pop growth is migration, not births. So we do get the Communist Party. Let's see who's in it. Armed forces. Okay. It's fair. They will not win. Although if the trade union switches, they will win. Right. Yeah, free trade party. Tons of votes. Got it. Because it is... Yeah, the free trade party, I think, is just going to keep winning these elections. Pretty much no matter what. Because we have landed voting, and they are the only ones with land. Because the aristocrats... There are no aristocrats. We don't have any rural stuff. So this also kind of makes expanding the rural stuff a little bit less appealing. As a general heuristic. The grand plan pays off, you don't say. Oh, baby. That's a nice one. Decrease loan interest rate. We're paying quite a bit in interest. We're actually going to increase the taxes a little bit. I thought we'd be coming out of this a little bit stronger, but we are not. And kind of 23 is, like, the target I was looking for. How much are we paying in welfare, actually? We have no unemployed, so nothing. Right? 86. $1.30. 18. Alright, how's our infrastructure look? We got quite a bit. Got like 50-ish. Are you fully employed? You are. Let's expand you. You're trying to employ? This is so close to 51, I'm just gonna up it. We get monitor. Nice. level up this. Two levels, I guess. Because we're not going to get electrical railways anytime soon. But now that it'll be on 51, we will stop auto-expanding. And this is both so productive and still can't employ people. The duel. Oh, please be market liberal, okay, and the communists. Let them fight. I think we want the communist to die. Don't think this is a communist run. He didn't die, damn. The military guy beat the other guy? Shocker. Partisan papers, you're telling me. Paper mill throughput, of course. United States offers to take on our debt. I don't think we can declare war on them if they take on our debt. How much debt is this, though? Our investment pool is huge. 5 mil? I mean, it will decay over time. The question is how long do we think it's going to be until we war them? I actually think it's going to be long enough that... Actually, wait, let's take a look. Yeah. I don't think we can dow them. Oh, this is such a tough decision. They can't use it to annex us. They could use it to pull us into their market, but we actually don't hate that. If we get freedom and then get pulled in their market, that's kind of fine. I think I'm gonna accept this. I'm not sure if that's the correct decision, but it seems fine. And I'm gonna call it an episode here. This episode's just been really chill. We got the oh wait, what have we done? We haven't gotten rayon yet. We're working on that. We got the synthetics, we're working towards art silk, so we took a screen of it, but we didn't even get it. It's just been, we finished up the laws we want, it's just been pretty chill. Chilling and expanding. We're now, I guess the biggest thing is we're over half the United States GDP just in Oklahoma. They have a GDP of 134 million, we have a GDP of, let's see, of 75 million, so you can see it here. We're over half their GDP, so this is kind of the story now. We're closing in on them. We should be able to, I think maybe two episodes from now, fight them, something like this. But we're going to, after we have like three more techs we really want this tech tree over here. In the production tree. We really want, art silk, electrical capacitors and railways, and then I suppose we make go combustion engine, because this will give us motorized. Of course, turning on motorized will be really uncomfortable, so maybe we don't do that, I'm not sure. And then we'll be able to come over here into the military one, right? Yeah, we could go elevators would be okay. Yeah, maybe we go elevators maybe we go elevators next for the increased construction, but after that, I think that we kind of want to try and make a big push to get NCO training before taking a fight with the United States, if we can. We still have several tier 3 techs to get, though, so maybe this is not the situation, but we can only have 200 battalions absolute max, so... we're in a bit of an awkward spot. We actually want to get mass conscription. Who supports it? The trade unions. Okay, so next time we get the trade unions in power, we'll have to go for this. Also the guy from the church. But this will allow us to have 200 battalions total instead of 150 with professional army. And our conscription center would be like double the size. And so maybe this is how we have to fight this out of fighting the United States. But even then, if they conscript as well, it's going to be rough. Like, we have to be ahead of them on tech, and I think we have to be either on NCOs or tanks to be able to fight this now. unless we experience some weird situation where they like have a civil war or something. Anyways, hope you enjoyed. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe, you know, the YouTube algorithm stuff, and have a good day.